put your hands together for David Kibuuka, everybody. David Kibuuka.
Hello. Hello. Yes, I am David, indeed. That is true. I started off by telling the truth. I am from South Africa, it's true. Yes, give me a round of applause. Give South Africa a round of applause. Yeah, yeah. Because we are the country that brought you Oscar Pistorius. Oscar really surprised the nation. He really surprised the nation. Because in South Africa, crime is seen as a black thing. So actually, crime is seen as a black thing in America as well. That's why I feel so at home here. Just need to get a bulletproof vest. I watch the news. No, because you really think that black people commit crimes in America. It's like it's a stereotype. You really think it. Because I'm thinking like Obama is about to leave the White House, and what's going to happen when he leaves? Is somebody going to go and, sorry, President Obama, but we counted the teaspoons before. It's a numbers thing. It's not you. It's just, you know, it's just it wasn't. It was, it's not a big thing, but if you could, it isn't a big thing, but it's not big. Don't even worry. I mean, what is six teaspoons between? What is that? No, because that's a stereotype. Then you have, because we were so shocked, because this happened to us, Oscar, you know. We were so shocked. And the second reason we were shocked was because we always thought that crime was an able-bodied thing. You know, like, you know the prime suspect. Whenever they have the prime suspect, he always have all his arms and all his legs. That's a big feature of the prime suspect. But then, because you never thought, did you think that disabled people wanted to shoot? I didn't know that they wanted to shoot. Like, you never thought that they were going to buying guns and going to target practice and buying bullets and things like that. I didn't know. We were shocked. I didn't know. Like, when you see them at war, you know, they're not allowed to go to war. But now we're like, damn. Why have we not allowed them to go to war? Why? We were discriminating against these people. They wanted to shoot. The thing is, we thought you want to shoot here, but they wanted to shoot pop, 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 pop. It was a height. We were discriminating according to height. That's the thing, which is terrible. They're dangerous. You guys have that war, the war against terror. That's why you're losing. Because you don't allow disabled people to fight for you. That's the thing. They're fearless. It's fearless. Because you know, if you've lost your legs, another arm, or whatever, I don't care. You know, I've learned to use shit. I've learned to live without an arm, so I might as well. You know, like, it's one of those. So now, because we still, South Africa is a very racial place. So we have, So now, because we have white people there. I know. We are shocked as well. We're like, how did you guys get here? Like, but they are there. And they think that they're perfect. They think that they're perfect. And Oscar now has put a blemish on their record. You know, him being white and disabled. It's a blemish. Because you know, like white folks, they also, because we have a black government. Then white folks will love saying that the black government will never succeed because our black president, Jacob Zuma, does not have a high school diploma. And I mean, because I'm like, obviously they have not seen George Bush. No, because he went to Harvard and he almost burnt down America. Twice. So that's the thing. And our president is too busy You know, because he was studying. He was in high school, and then this opening of the presidency came up. And so then he had to quit. No, that's what happens. You can't, because there's a conflict of interest. Class president, and then now president of a country. It's weird. Because then who does the principal talk to? Who does the principal talk to? Because the principal is like, yeah, but you're the president. Oh, you're going to have to quit. You're going to have to quit. And then when you're finished, then you can come back and finish off your term learning to read. That's what happened. That's what happened. And so now what white folks, in because of the blemish, now they want us to forget. Like Oscar comes on TV and then they forget about it. It's not such a big thing. Forget about it. Just forget about it. And we can't forget. Us black people, we're not gonna forget. We're holding on to this one. We're holding on. No, we're holding on to it. It's like it's almost like amnesia is white people's favorite disease. No, because black folks, we don't get amnesia. We don't get amnesia. It's just one of those things. Like, have you seen those? They send those adverts to America because you guys, to give us money. You think that we can survive on $1 a day. You know? No, I mean, it's cool. But that's what you do. But we don't get Ebola. We can get Ebola, but not amnesia. You never see an ad, you know. Donate $1. And you can save an African child from amnesia. Giving him the chance to remember that he's starving. No. Can't have amnesia. But we do have things. We do have things in Africa. And the real reason that we don't have amnesia is because it's a cultural thing. So now, as African people, what we do is when we give and lend money to our extended family, like our relatives, it's quite a big thing. We give and lend money. And white folks do that as well. They do that as well. The only difference is white folks, they get a receipt. They don't just give you money. They get a receipt. You know, it'd be there, Bob, I'm going to give my twin brother. And they get a receipt. Another receipt. Can I have your social security number? Next of kin, owe me. Okay, I'll just write that down. Here's the $2.17. So, but now with black people, first of all, it's very difficult to get hold of a black person, just as a thing. And this is a worldwide phenomenon. It's just to get hold of a black, you know, why? It's because of the concept of unknown numbers. This is, you know, the concept of unknown, it's basically extreme sports for us. That's why we don't participate in extreme sports, because of the concept of the unknown number. Because like a white person will, the phone will ring. The phone. I wonder who this is. Hello? Yes, it's George here. Confident. Black person. I wonder who this is. You were saying, we can't. But now it's tough. It's tough in the world to be black. So now what happens is we have a different condition when we, you know, borrow and lend. You know how it is. It's hard to be black. It's hard. So now we have to tell the person that we have to tell them, you know, you need to stay alive. Stay alive. I know it's tough there with the cops trying to shoot you, but stay alive. Stay alive. Or you know that song? Let that be your theme song while you have my money. Let that be your theme song. So that's what happens. So now what we do is, the whole Oscar thing, is I blame all white people for it. I've never met you, but I blame you. You have a bit. There's something. One millionth of a percent you blame. Like, I have a friend. He has white. He's a proper white person. He's got white man, white wife, white things, white car, just shit that's white everywhere. And then, it's one of those. Yes. And then he had a baby. And then they brought that baby. And everyone went, oh, look at the baby. the baby's so cute. I was like, that baby will shoot you. That baby will shoot you, my friend. Baby will shoot you. But it's then, so, and I think they're going to turn this Oscar thing into a movie. I heard they're going to turn it into a movie with Ryan Gosling, I think. No, that wasn't a joke. That was just what I read. So, and I like movies. So this is what we call a segue. I move from that to the thing I'm going to talk about in movies. No, but you know, my favorite kind of movie. My favorite kind of movie is those movies where somebody dies in someone's arms right at the beginning of the movie. You know those ones? Like you guys saw Braveheart, Mel Gibson. Yes, the racist / person. So then, Mel Gibson. Because in Braveheart, his wife died right at the beginning of the movie, and that's the bit I like. And no, not like that. His wife died. And then you realize that women are so emotional. Under all circumstances, they're emotional, because the English had killed the world. They had shot her. And then she was there. She said, Braveheart. Braveheart. Promise me that you will avenge my death. I will avenge your death. And promise me, Braveheart, that you will remember me forever. Oh, you're such a wonderful lass. I will remember you forever. And promise me, Braveheart, that you will never be with another woman as long as you live. Don't you have somewhere to be? That's what I like Braveheart. And then you know you're the epicenter of, well, you steal you get the technology from the Chinese, then you rebrand it as your own, then sell it to us. So, no, that's what you do. You're sure, that's what happens. You didn't do it. The way you're doing it is, I didn't do that. No, but the nation does it. So I'm talking about the nation. Then, because sometimes our technologies are a bit behind. Like, we still, there's, you know, tapes? Cassettes. You know, like those things, that's like Brontosaurus Rex or something like that to you guys. No, but to us, there is a thing called cassettes there. We do have, because you can get Justin Timberlake has just released a new cassette. It's a good one. You see, those. So then, but then now we realize that. But then we also do have those MP3s and half. And now, because some people, what do you do with it? Because you guys are consumers, so you just throw the thing away. But you throw the radio away. Throw the radio away. But now we can't. What are you going to do? There's still a cassette player. Now, why would I need a cassette? So one thing, because you guys don't have cassettes. And you realize, in the world of cassettes, if you can remember, that you would tape, because with MP3s, you can tape like 5 weeks. You can have 5 weeks on your computer. But with cassettes, you could have 5 songs. And then the 6th song, you have half of it. And then the other half you put on side B. But then you'd go to nightclubs, and DJs just play these songs. But we're cool. We just continue. We just continue like nothing has happened. DJs play these cassettes. We just continue like nothing has happened. Because you're there, having a good time. I'm every woman. It's all in. Me. And you have things like internet radio here. Internet radio. Streaming. I thought there was fish involved. You know, you make yourself look like an idiot. Streaming. Yes, I was streaming. The stream. Spring water. Then they're like, what are you talking about? Streaming with the stream. Streams. Very confusing. Because you think you could just make up new words. That's the thing I think. Why don't you make up new words? Why do you use old words and then we look like idiots? Because there's make up new words so that we can know what you're not talking about fish. Make up bloody new words.
you.
But we still have the when we tape from radio, because you just download. So we tape from the radio. And then we still have our high, it's called a hi-fi stereo. And then they have a record button. Because they make these things in the East, and the Eastern people just decided that they can't trust the Western people to press just record. Something big happened in the East where they were like, no. No, we don't want that to happen again. We don't want it to happen again. What was it? It's a secret, but we don't want it to happen again. So then they put the record as well. So then if you just press, I mean the play, if you just press record, nothing happens. So you have to press record and play. At the same time. But then the song is not coming now because you're getting it from the radio. So then you have to press the pause. So you're ready. And then that's why the pause sometimes it didn't work so well after a while. Started to do that thing where it's press pause. But our DJs, they don't want us to, because we when you get a sweetheart, you want to get a sweetheart, you make a mixtape when you were young. You know, to express what you felt, yeah. It was expression. The DJs didn't want us to have sweethearts. Like me and you, DJs didn't want that to happen. Because you'd be there, the song would come. You'd unpause.
I'll make love to you like you want me to. And I'll...
This is Winston Bean Gauzy, and you're listening to Boys to Men, the Philadelphia Quartet, all the way from America. Now in Africa, there's a whole generation of girls who do not know that some songs have third verses. Because you just have to cut it there. Cut it there. I love to read. The last novel I read was Humpty Dumpty. And very good. And no. So then you go, so I was reading Humpty Dumpty. And I thought to myself, Humpty Dumpty's parents were messed up. I mean, who calls their kid Humpty when your surname is Dumpty? Like, I mean, you can't have a job if you're called Humpty Dumpty. You can't be a president of a country. Like, they go to the UN and they're, je ne sais quoi le plus, Americano presidente, Barack Obama. Je ne sais quoi le plus président d'Afrique du Sud. Humpty Dumpty, Humpty Dumpty. No. Can't be a doctor. Would Dr. Humpty Dumpty please report to surgery? Would Dr. Humpty Dumpty please report to surgery? We have a man here who has fallen off a wall. And we cannot put him back together at all. No, you guys have been a wonderful first crowd. And let's meet again soon. Thank you very much. Cheers.